Hello friends, in the last video we have seen question number 5 based diagrams and tables. In this video I will cover passages. Total they have given us 5 passages for practice. So let's discuss the passage. Okay. Okay, now let's see the first passage. First passage tells about 3 questions have been asked, 1, 1, and 2. See, Mona visits a shopping mall near her residence. She shops for monthly groceries, which include rice, wheat, sugar, cooking oil, and pulses. So she is visiting mall and she is purchasing few grocery items. She purchases additional quantity of sugar, much more than her monthly requirement. Anticipating, anticipate means what? To predict the future. किंवा पुढचा विचार करून म्हणजे असं काहीतरी तिला अँटिसिपेट करणं इन ऍडव्हान्स पुढचा विचार करणं दॅट प्राइसेस मे राईज इन द कमिंग डेज व्हॉट शी हॅज डन शी हॅज अँटिसिपेटेड दॅट बिकॉज ऑफ सम फेस्टिवल्स आर कमिंग सो शी थॉट दॅट देअर मे राईज इन द प्राइसेस ऑफ शुगर सो शी हॅज परचेस ऍडिशनल शुगर शी ऑब्झर्व्स टू डिफरंट क्वालिटीज दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॅरेग्राफ देन सेकंड शी ऑब्झर्व्स two different qualities of tur dal out of which one quality is inferior and other is superior she does not purchase the low quality tur dal even though its price is comparatively lower there are two types one is cheaper one is costlier even though cheaper we say that according to law of demand higher the price lower will be the purchase demand quantity demanded but here what happened even though the price is low she has not purchased those that quality inferior quality tur dal now based on this the first question is identify the exception to the law of demand exceptions are the cases where law of demand is not applicable what our law of demand tells when price rises demand falls and when price falls demand rises but in the case of exceptions there is direct relationship so when price rises demand also rises and when price falls demand also falls this is the case of exceptions so what they are asking identify the exception to the law of demand in the given passage with reference to purchase of additional quantities of sugar much more than monthly requirement so you can say your answer should contain speculation we know speculation is what we are anticipate the future and we do not behave in a normal way म्हणजे आपल्याला आपण future मध्ये असं वाटलं की because of festival prices rise होणार आहेत म्हणून आताच आपण जसं आपण आता लॉकडाऊनच्या ह्याच्यामध्ये बघतोय कोरोनाच्या ह्याच्यामध्ये की अरे बापरे लॉकडाऊन होणार किंवा आता सगळं बंद होणार आहे म्हणून काय करतात लोक गर्दी करतात आणि म्हणजे स्पेक्युलेट करतात अँटिसिपेट करतात सेम वे ड्युरिंग फेस्टिवल्स ऑल्सो वी अँटिसिपेट किंवा ओनियन्सच्या प्राइसेसच्या बाबतीत पण आपण बऱ्याचदा स्पेक्युलेट करतो की बाबा पाऊस खूप पडला किंवा पाऊस नाही पडला किंवा लॉकडाऊन मुळे असं काही रिझन्स असतील की ज्याच्यामुळे प्राइस ऑफ ओनियन्स विल राईज सो इवन दो टुडे इट इज कॉस्टलियर वी परचेस मोर किंवा आपण बऱ्याचदा स्टॉक करून ठेवतो अशा वेळेला सो यू कॅन राईट as the Mona is purchasing more sugar than her monthly requirement because festivals are coming soon so she anticipate that price may rise I am telling in my own words you can write in your own words but remember this should be there in your answer so festivals are coming soon so coming days due to festivals okay coming soon so she has purchased more quantities than her usual requirement okay so because in the speculation we predict the future and we do not behave in a normal way okay so next identifies for one mark only identify the kind of goods with reference to law it's law low quality sorry identify with reference to low quality means see in given goods we have seen that there are two types of goods one is inferior goods and that is also called given goods and another is superior goods so About Turdal, you can write that here. Identify the kind means inferior or Giffen goods or low quality goods. What you will say in Giffen goods or Giffen paradox says that when the price of inferior goods falls, people purchase less of it and invest that amount to purchase superior quality of goods. It's of one mark only. Just so give 2-3 lines explanation. Whatever you have understood about Giffen goods, don't write everything about Giffen goods, then England example. No need of writing it because they have given the passage and they expect us to write from the passage only. Express your personal opinion based on above. Now see, personal opinion, it may differ from person to person, but normally what they expect, we have to talk about the exceptions, because if you read the passage, two exceptions have been covered by them. One is speculation and another is Giffen goods. So you can say that in the above passage, they are talking about exceptions to the law of demand. Generally, rational consumer purchases more quantity of goods when price is low and purchases less when price is high. But in the case of exception, he does not behave like this. So in this passage, they have given two examples, that is speculation and Giffen goods. They have given about the speculation and Giffen goods. So exceptions are the cases where law of demand is not applicable. The rational consumer do not behave in that manner. Okay. So with this 2 marks, so at least write 6 to 7 lines, but you should write it related to passage only. Don't write whole whatever the exceptions you know from the textbook. Don't write, they don't expect such type of things from you. Now the second passage. Amul is the first choice of so many ice cream lovers in India, among the top ice cream brand category. Amul brand, they have started the passage with telling something about Amul. Established Anand, Gujarat. Second, okay, then second they have mentioned about the Vadilal, then Cornetto, Magnum, then Hindustan Unilever, Mother Dairy, Hamfor. Means they have, in short, you can see that they have mentioned us different companies providing ice cream in India. So you can, in the last paragraph, Amul, they have one more thing they have mentioned, that ice cream market also has local and less popular brands apart from top brands. Means in short, they have shown, they're telling us different types of companies providing ice cream in India. Other than this, they have mentioned that there are local brands also, not so much popular. Okay, so these are the things they have mentioned. Then in the last, they have mentioned about Amul's Guinness record of running the longest ever advertising campaign, advertising strategy of Amul and everything they have mentioned. Okay, now identify the most important feature of ice cream. According to me, as lot of companies have been mentioned, so you can write that it's a competitive market as lot of players are there. So we can say that this is the type of monopolistic competition. Okay, the direct answer has been not given, otherwise they directly ask from the passage only, but according to me, this can be the answer. Monopolistic competition, it's a competitive market, lot of players are there, ice cream players are there. So I can say that it is monopolistic. Next, identify the type of cost. See, they are spending advertisement cost and all. So type of cost, advertising campaign strategies, we call it as selling cost. You can write about selling, what exactly selling cost is the special feature of monopolistic competition, where they try to sell their product. They try to tell us that how their product is different, and for that they incur the cost, that is called selling cost. Okay. Express your personal opinion about the ice cream market based on the above information. Now see, your personal opinion about the ice cream market, you can tell, and they have told us based on the above information only. So you can write there are different players in the market, mention their name, Mother Dairy and everything, Fufai, Amul and all. Then you can say that Amul has recorded the Guinness book for running the longest ever advertising campaign. These players, then we have ice cream market has also local and less popular brands apart from the top brands. Mention from the, and especially mention that advertising strategy of Amul through digital marketing. You can tell about this, all these things. Don't write all this Amul started in Gujarat and something, no need of it. Just mention all the players and about the advertising strategy. And one more, ice cream market has local less popular brand apart from top brand. See, you are going to mention this part also, so you should then mention all these companies and about the advertising. This is sufficient to write 2 marks. No need of writing about history of Amul. Next paragraph. So this is personal opinion, but it should be strict to the passage only. Don't write anything, whatever you feel. It's not an essay type question, imaginary type of question. Okay. Then in India, market for automobiles, third passage, huh? Market for automobiles, cement, steel, aluminium are the examples of oligopolistic market. We know that what is oligopoly market? Oligopoly market are the market where there are few sellers. Okay. So in all these markets, there are few firms for each particular product. Duopoly is a special. Duopoly means what? There are only two players in which there are exactly two sellers. Under duopoly, it is assumed that product sold by the two firms is homogeneous and there is no substitute. Explain where two companies, examples where two companies control a large proportion of market are PepsiCo. They have given the example of duopoly, that is Pepsi, Coca-Cola, Airbus, Boeing in the commercial large jet aircraft market. Operating system for smartphones. Okay, they have talked about the mobile Android phones and software computer operating systems. Okay, now first question is give example of oligopolistic market in India. See, in the first para only, the first line only, they have mentioned in India market for automobiles, cement and are the examples of oligopolistic market. One more, I am doubtful about it, they have given in that, but to be on safer side, right? In cement industry, we have Ambuja Cement. They have not mentioned, but and Aditya Birla. You can mention this company. Actually, they have not mentioned. They have told the examples of oligopolistic market, but specific, if you want to tell one answer, attend one example, you can write that in your, means it's completely up to you whether you will write or not. Then next, explain the concept of duopoly with a suitable example. See, in the passage only, they have with a suitable example from the passage only. Okay, so they have mentioned about the duopoly. It is assumed that the product sold by two firms is homogeneous, and example, write these two examples, Airbus and Pepsi related. Okay, so answers are in the passage only. Express your opinion. Now this is for 2 marks, personal opinion based on above. So you can write about the types of market. Here duopoly and oligopoly has been discussed. Then you also add what exactly duopoly and what exactly oligopoly means, few sellers, and these things you can add. About the examples also write down, operating system about and Google Android systems, Android phones and operating system. You can tell the examples also in India, how oligopolistic market plays role. You can write these things. It's of 2 marks. So write 5 to 6 lines from the passage only. Next. Now the next is regarding budget and corona. You read it. I will directly discuss the answers. What is the percentage increase in the provision for healthcare? Now you can see here. See, significant increase in the allocation of healthcare by 137%. So your answer should be by 137% increase in the provision for healthcare. Second, mention the sectors that have been promoted. Promote, instead of promote, they have used here the word boost. So see, in the last paragraph only, attempts have been made to boost infrastructure. So promoted means infrastructure, education, agriculture, production, employment, generation, industry. Okay, only this much you can write. Next, express your opinion based on the above. Now see, based on the above means what? You can start your answer by telling that in the first paragraph, they have told about the coronavirus. So you can say that last year, economy was badly affected by COVID. Okay. So your answer will start with last year, economy was badly affected by COVID. It affected the economy of the country as well as whole world. Still, one of the main feature of the budget is They have talked here about this. See, this is the first paperless budget in the history of India. You have to mention this. Then at the same time, third post-independence budget to be presented at time when the economy is shrinking. And this, even though COVID situation was there, slow economy, still or we can say contraction in the economy was there, still budget shows a fiscal deficit of more than 5%. We can write that also. Then mention about the healthcare also. These things are sufficient. From the passage only they have told us. And the budget has provided, see, the budget, this also, the budget has provided some credit to agricultural health facilities, PDS, public power distribution scheme, small and medium enterprises. You can write these things also. Okay, so this is sufficient because they have mentioned, write it from the passage only. Now the last part, last passage. Post-liberalization. See this, if you read this passage, you can see that they are talking about the, we know this LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. Liberalization means what is it? Thoda sa freedom deno. Hey, Narasimha Rao chi committee 1991 chi policy, tyachyamadhye LPG vagare, new economic policy vagare hi concept hai. Hi aplyala 11th standard la hoti, and that is very important. तर त्या पोस्ट लिबरलायझेशन म्हणजे लिबरलायझेशन प्री लिबरलायझेशन म्हणजे लिबरलायझेशनच्या आधीची आणि पोस्ट लिबरलायझेशन म्हणजे लिबरलायझेशनच्या नंतरच्या कंडिशनच्या बाबतीत हा पॅरेग्राफ बँकेशी रिलेटेड आहे. सो आयडेंटिफाय द एरियाज ऑफ डायव्हर्सिफिकेशन अंडरटेकन बाय पब्लिक सेक्टर बँक्स पोस्ट लिबरलायझेशन. पहिल्याच लाईन इथं पोस्ट लिबरलायझेशन पब्लिक सेक्टर बँक्स हॅव डायव्हर्सिफाईड. डायव्हर्सिफाय म्हणजे चेंज होणं. नॉन ट्रॅडिशनल ऍक्टिव्हिटीज म्हणजे ट्रॅडिशनल टिपिकल ऍक्टिव्हिटीज संपल्या आणि वेगळ्या चालू झाल्या. मग आन्सर विल बी नॉन डायव्हर्सिफिकेशन अंडरटेकन बाय पब्लिक सेक्टर बँक्स इन दी हेल्या एक्सेट्रा. अँड ऑल्सो यू कॅन राईट अँड ऑल्सो लिझिंग हायर परचेस. Also, para-banking means other than typical banking systems, typical banking activities. Para-banking means typical je loan dena, loan ghena, ha sagya goshti aahet na, tyachya shivay leasing, hire purchase, factor servicing, ha goshti pan bank karayla lagli. So you have to mention both the points. Okay, I will again mention this and this also for the first. Okay, then mention the financial services offered under retail banking. Now see retail banking. Okay, it's here only, huh? This is about second. Retail banking offers financial services, so your answer, housing loans, loans for purchase of consumer durables, auto loans, education loans, credit cards, etc. Next, give your personal opinion based on above passage. Now see, you can say liberalization has proved to be great boon. Shap ki vardan manto na. So it's one type of vardan. Boon. Boon to the banking system. It diversified. Ata hai sagami chachatla sithe. Diversified banking into banking from traditional to non-traditional. Manje typical je traditional kamu hoti techatna te non-traditional lagele. Man non-traditional activities aplela hai pahila point madhe. Pahila answer lila na merchant banking vagere he kalde. You will cover that also. Then it also started retail banking, merchant banking, and he je na portfolio management. He kai kai thode 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 shabd ahet nahi sagle. Ithe life insurance vagere he sagle cover karun. You can write your own opinion. Okay. So with this, we have finished our question number 5 passage. I have made one video for this. Objective type of questions I have finished. Now the things only explain the concept part is remaining. That I will cover in the next video. Thank you.